Hey guys, Brian Robinson here with this week's save analysis. We're going to take a look at Roberto Luongo. A little bit of a post-to-post movement while staying down using the lean here. We're going to see as soon as the puck carrier gets the puck within the trapezoid, you can see Luongo drops down that lead pad. He's not fully leaning into the post here. That guy behind the net's not an immediate threat, so if this guy was above the goal line or extended in the corner, you would hopefully not see any of that space open up there. One thing I really like here is Roberto's back leg. You'll notice it's extended. He's almost in a half butterfly. Got this from Magnus Olsson of Blue Crease over in Sweden. We call this position A. It's position A. You're leaning into the post. You're using that back skate as leverage. It's also there to fill space. There's a quick pass out in front. You simply transfer your weight to position B, which if we move ahead just a little bit here, you're going to see comes right here. He drops that leg down. He shifts his weight. Couple things I want to take a look at before he moves off the post. He has his stick blade over. It's nice and active. His eyes are on the puck. He doesn't cheat off that short side post. He waits till he reads that player going behind the net and making the pass. Then he turns his head. Now this downward post-to-post movement all starts with the upper body. You're going to notice before he even drops that leg, his upper body starts to shift. The leg drops. And then the last thing he does is kick that post with his left leg. That's going to help him get over pretty easily there. Gets over nice and big, sees the pass out in front. Great visual attachment. Tracks it all the way into the body. You can see here as the pass comes out, Roberto's nice and square, and he opts to do a quick knee reaction, which I'm not the biggest fan of right here. As soon as he lifts that leg up, he's actually going to have a hole if that puck is shot hard enough to go right under his arm, pretty much next to his elbow. I would rather have seen him stay square. Maybe a center shift, a little bit of a kick off that post just to move a little bit towards his left to help this puck hit him in the chest. Instead, it kind of hits him in the cuff, handcuffs him, but since he has his eyes on the puck, he's able to track it in, pull it in and cover it up, get the quick whistle.